this is going to be our 20th show. And yeah.
Today we're going to have our very first fashion show meeting. This is April, and there's been a lot of work that has happened prior to this meeting, especially on the collection.
We just put together a document that kind of went through various elements of the TV show, and it'd be nice to get everybody's thoughts and comments and feelings on it, really. All the collection looks were fantastic. We really liked that there was some actual kind of moments within the show. So for instance, Ali and Adriana was a really nice moment.
Yeah.
It just kind of breaks up that procession. Ed, you had a note about how do we make the closing angel moment as big as the opening moment. After last year, my thought was, do we in some way construct a theatrical sequence with a beginning, a middle, and an end?
To your point, I think we should, you know, just really kind of shake up our thinking processes.
Yeah.
When do you think we'll have talent?
Rihanna has agreed to do the show. She's got a
she
new album.
She called us from Hawaii. Yes,
and she wants to do it.
It'd be great.
One of the things that happened with last year and adding Ed Sheeran and adding Hozier, it was a great show.
We had four artists in the show last year, and it was the best show yet, and it rated really well, and it was exciting. And so I think we keep that formula.
In my head, the only thing that matters is the TV show, obviously, because millions, if not billions, of people see it. My role is to constantly battle for the lens.
I found out over the weekend, Chip said that we may be able to get the Armory back if we want it. That's going to be a decision of, I think, Renee and Hamish and team.
So what's the downside of the Javits Center, the ceiling height?
Yeah.
I don't know. I mean, there was a lot of advantages to having a big space for hair and makeup and all the press.
How big a camera question is it for you guys?
It's enormous.
Enormous.
Yeah, it will make the show very different. So when designing the show, we'd have to really think cleverly and carefully about how, I'm not saying we can't do it there, but I am saying we need to think. My instinct is, if we've got the Armory, game set, match the Armory, but if we have got the Javits, the show's going to come really, really down.
It's the Armory.
Yeah. Oh, jeez. I mean,
it's not even complicated. Yeah, it's the Armory.
I'd love to start with the collection. I think the collection informs some of the creative direction.
These are so cool.
So we're going to start with Boho Psychedelic. Basically, this was born out of creating something of the rock and roll time, Woodstock, Janis Joplin.
She's a rock and roll girl, but she's, it's luxe and rich, so she had some money to have some cool clothes made.
Okay, exotic butterflies. What we wanted to explore was the richness of the color of the butterflies, of the texture of the feathers. It's a more abstract thing than psychedelic boho, but it still will give us a lot of rich, yeah. Portrait of an Angel. It's very tulle, dusty pinks, dusty blues. So it's this very fragile, feminine moment. This is the pink section. Basically, it was a celebration of all American girls. So there's all these sorts of iconic
Americana
referenced women. So this is Ice Angels. She's a ski angel, but a much more focus on luxuries.
We wanted to take it to
a sporty
direction, but still luxe.
Firework. Wings that become Catherine wheels, that will be made of feathers, that will rotate. We're trying to address it in a different way. Lots of really large, vividly colored, jewel-like embroideries, and that's it.
It's important that build a show and a balance through the show and a kind of crescendo over time. What would you have as the finale at the moment?
God, I'm...
I know, right? I mean, we won't lock in today.
No.
Psychedelic.
But wouldn't you start with psychedelic?
Well, I mean,
yeah,
it's
I think
weird.
It'd start with
you
psychedelic.
Start or
yeah.
End with it.
If you're going to establish at the front end of it, I'd start with psychedelic.
It could be really... It's going to be so colorful and it's almost like when we did Circus to open and there's lots of texture and lots of color and stuff going on. If we can manage to recreate something of that excitement, that would be amazing.
One of the main things that we really need to accomplish between now and June 6th, which is our next meeting, is really the space, the venue, what it's going to look like.
We feel very confident that it's going to be an exciting show, but the pieces are all still moving.
Lighting elements of all kinds of different shapes and everything like that that are highly programmable.
I'm nervous about this one and I can't quite get it into my head.
I disagree with Hamish wholeheartedly.
You really, really got to be able to look at your stuff and say, is it working or not working?
Time of year where I like to scare you guys by saying the number of days there are until the fashion show. 67 days.
I like that.
That was a good reaction.
We've been looking at all of this stuff for months. What sections go where, what models go where, and it's very far along.
Today was the last group production meeting for everyone to get together, to see everything one last time before we really go off and put the final touches on the show.
At this point, is it worth fast-forwarding to show day? Can you go back to your image?
Yeah. I mean, I personally love these pieces. I'd hate for these to be killed on the day because...
We didn't think about it enough now.
Is this better to be closer to it or farther from it?
It works both ways, and I don't actually have a super strong opinion either way. You could put it either side, and you know, actually, okay, I'll make a decision. Lampposts this side,
architectural stuff the other side.
Indecision in what I do is a bad thing. So you're either decisively right or decisively wrong. But indecision is just like everything just grinds to a halt, and you end up with mediocrity, which is never great.
President of Universal Records called me yesterday and he said, you know, I know you'd inquired about Selena, and he said, we'd really like to try to make this happen. Tell me what you need and we'll send you whatever songs you want. We'll do it in any of this. And he said, we do research with her fans, and the number one thing in the world that they want to see her on is your show. When we come to a talent's manager with the combination of the Victoria's Secret show, which is unlike anything else, and they don't get another venue like that all year long. There just isn't one.
We feel so well planned, and everything is all, you know, buttoned up. We know the sections, we know the music artists that we want to go after, we know what things are looking like, but it's still now crunch time.
OMG.
What the?
It's incredible, right?
Yeah.
I know, it's firework. Like,
I'm so excited.
Yeah.
I mean, we're going to see Monica.
Everyone has a lot of, you know, wonderful ideas for the show. And then it's really, you know, herding it all together. And what's happening?
Oh, wow.
Oh, my God. I think it's the most intricate piece we have ever done. That's a happy moment. You never know, you know, when you sketch it and then design it and do the fittings, because that is custom made for her, you never know how it's going to come in. Honestly, that exceeds my expectation. That looked amazing.
Working under the assumption we're starting the show with Boho Psychedelic, to disperse as many as we can lighting elements of all kinds of different shapes and everything like that that are highly programmable. We're probably going to be mixing different types of sources.
I'm nervous about this one. I can't quite get it into my head. The mix of the two techniques and the reveal of the first girl. It makes me nervous, and I'm not sure that it sets the kind of the agenda of the show as we have in previous years.
It was very important for me as one of the executive producers to really listen to Hamish and listen to what his feedback was, because it has to work for him. It can't just be beautiful and
very rare that such a big company is so brave and so creative with their concepts. You know, we realized it was a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to do something this artistic and this out there for a company that's as big as they are.
It's more difficult for us to work with new people all the time. It's a lot of work to have somebody take what their skill is and to adapt it to a wing that's made for a model.
My origins were in theater, and then I got into Broadway shows, operas. From doing that work, I happened to get a call from Victoria's Secret. What our shop does, we make a lot of the bigger wings. We've been doing this since 2009. It's been really exciting from the beginning. Every year, it's a new challenge. That's what they like to say. We're pushing you to your limits to do something new.
We're always about finding the most relevant artisan for the piece. And whether they're working in their kitchen or as part of a global brand is irrelevant to us. We care about the product.
You're at the Lost Art Studio. We do custom leather. Everything we do is one of a kind because we work with natural materials. The music industry, the fashion industry, any of the creative industries, we pretty much have our client base. People like Carlos Santana, Steven Tyler, Lady Gaga, Rihanna, the list goes on. For Victoria's Secret, they have their image already in mind of what they need to have done. They just need someone who could make it really sexy and complement their lingerie.
Wow, that looks amazing.
We could do with some fringing on the front after all that. Mm-hmm. Like the sketch, yeah.
All right.
It's cool to make something from nothing. Like, it's just a pile of stuff laying on a table flat, and next thing you know, you have this amazing little sculpture.
I think that's great. I'm so happy with it.
It's cool. What we need to do,
rather than it being stripy, I feel it feels a bit banded. Mm-hmm. It sort of needs to degradate as red in the center, then yellow at the end.
We're into the second or third month now of working on the pieces, and everything is almost at the point where they're finished.
So killer, man.
Babes. Yeah, I love
that
it.
That is,
shout
wow,
out Jimi
wow.
Hendrix for you guys.
The fringing is so much
better. Yeah, the fringe is so cool.
Better.
There's a bunch of surprises today. Do you know?
No.
Cat out of the bag? I don't know
no.
if you guys are, like, I'm
what?
Looking.
What?
No?
No?
Okay. Surprise.
Oh, you made it anyway. You are so funny. I love it. You're like, here it is. I don't care. Wow. Cute.
I'm about movement, so I wanted to demonstrate that things could be done where it still moves and still sexy. I think it went really well.
So,
I'm a bit
confused. No, what I thought was going to happen was that they were going to be more
3D.
Yeah.
What we can do is add thicker levels, so make it poke out more.
I think what I'd like to do is create like more cylindrical shapes to give it much more 3D.
Okay.
What I have a problem with when anything's that flat becomes like a sail. It's about making the show the best it can be, and if we have faltered along the way by not delivering the information correctly or by being too fearful of upsetting someone, that would be disastrous for the show.
I was surprised, but I really agree with their comments. It was good to hear them, so I think now I know how we can make the wing better.
The next essential element to the show that's coming up is our casting.
There are girls, as we're speaking, who are working out 2-3 hours a day, every day, just for the casting. I know that is a fact.
The show is 10 days away. Every model in the world wants to be in this show, so it's going to be hard. It's going to be a very difficult couple of days.
I had probably well over 400 or 500 models submitted to me for consideration. I saw close to 300 in the first 2 days of casting, which I do on my own with my team. And in the 2 days of callbacks, I try to keep it to a maximum of 100 girls.
You just kind of have to relax. They're all lovely people. They're all smiling. And you kind of just have to just shake off the nerves. Have fun with it, basically. To prepare for this show, I like to get in my underwear, put my speakers on, practice my walk in my tiny little apartment in Harlem.
You're meant to be objective about it, but you know all the girls, you know how hard they've worked for it. A few of them showed their emotions, but they all feel that way. Every one of them feels that way.
There's several that were either fighting back tears or literally crying here today because there's such a buildup and they've been working for it and wanting it so badly.
Every year it feels like it's the very, very first show. And one thing that I do all year long is really try to work as hard as I can so I can deserve to be here. Be part of the moment that only happens at the show, at the Victoria's Secret Fashion Show. It's very, it's like, God.
The minute a model starts working with Victoria's Secret, you can kind of hear the champagne popping in the offices across model world, because once, you know, the phone rang and they asked for her, the career just kind of explodes.
And I know how hard they've worked for it, and hardly any of them will make it, and a lot of them deserve to make it.
You have to just encourage them that, you know, this that it's just not their time, but that doesn't mean no forever, and to kind of keep your hopes up and keep working forward.
That's my second year I'm doing the casting, and same thing, same nervous.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Right.
Yes. Thank you. I step up my workout, you know, eating right. I definitely learned a lot more about nutrition this year, and I think it's definitely gave me some better results than last year. I'm very happy this year.
There is no room to hide. There is no airbrushing. There is no, you know, you have to bring it. And that's what this interaction is really important for.
You want to look very confident, and you want to feel confident. You don't even just want to look confident. You want to know that all your hard work has paid off, and this is like the moment that you've been waiting for.
Models are no longer just pretty cover girls. People want to know who they are. They want to know her background, what she does when she's not working. They want to know, like, they want to know her.
Hi.
Hi, Gigi.
Hello, everyone.
What are you doing on November 9th and 10th?
I don't know.
Why don't you come join us?
Really?
Yeah!
Oh, yay!
Where are you from?
I'm from Russia.
Germany.
Brussels.
Peru originally.
Brazil from the south.
From Nepal.
Tanzania.
India.
Poland.
Denmark.
Reunion Island.
I'm from Reunion Island.
Where is Reunion Island?
It's a bit crazy because Victoria's Secret is a really amazing show.
You look well, you look very good.
So I'm trying to be as comfortable as I can and to smile with people and like be happy and have fun, because I think it's the whole point of Victoria's Secret.
We've had 2 days of castings and now our job is to go and review everything. Let it go. So if there's 45 girls on the show, I wouldn't fight for anyone that's not up there already.
She exudes glamour, that girl. There's no question.
She's good on the runway. She's powerful.
There's no question. And she's in better, I think she's in better shape than she's been in some time.
Can I move those three girls over?
Wait, no.
No, not yet. We're still in the middle of it. Honestly, that side of the board for me is more relevant than this side of the board.
They were just, they glowed. They had what Sophia calls the magic dust. These girls are all physical phenomenons, all of them.
It's quite exciting because everything's happening right now. We just had to make it much more stunning. We feel like we're all in Camp Victoria's Secret. Everybody flies in from out of town, and now we just put the show together.
Mighty city has stood proud in England for over 2,000 years. It has withstood wars, plagues, and fire. but remained unbowed. This city has ruled a global empire on which the sun never set, while celebrating tradition and royalty in equal measure.
Yeah. Girl. Right now.
We're so excited to be in London and all be together on the plane, in the hotel, on the bus. It's like school.
My dad is British, so I grew up in London and I feel very English in my roots, so it feels like I'm going home.
Victoria's Secret Angels have landed in London.
We're at the Victoria's Secret store in London, and it's been crazy. There's like so many photographers and fans, and we weren't expecting all this.
I haven't seen the venue. We're going after this, and we're going to have the rehearsal, and then I'm definitely going to get into the mood, because we're going to wear our wings, and we're going to hear the music, and it's finally here.
Oh my God, look at the floor.
Wild. The floors are all these incredible LED lights. It's like lit up as you're walking. It's just so beautiful.
There are more models than ever. There's 47 models. There are more outfits than ever.
This is my first time. And now I see this. It's like a dream come true.
It's beautiful to see all the ideas come together and then see their appreciation of them. It's always the best part.
Excited to London because my dad's here, my siblings are in the crowd, my nephews. This year I'm opening the segment Dream Girls. It's my first time opening a segment, and one of my best friends is performing during it, Taylor Swift, so it's gonna be really fun, and I'm so excited I get to open this part.
Send the talent now, send the talent now.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Coming up after the break.
And later, Ariana Grande, Hozier, and more Taylor Swift. Only CBS.
Hi, London.
I think with Adriana and Alessandra, we've been lucky enough to work with two of the greatest models in the history of the world.
They are the quintessential Victoria's Secret angels. They are sexy and beautiful and voluptuous and curvy, and they really, truly are great friends.
We know each other from Brazil, from when we started, so we were like both 15. In Brazil, we have this magazine for teenagers, and she always did the covers. I would see her, and I thought she was beautiful. I'm like, this girl is amazing. When I first did the show, that's, I think, when we bonded.
Warm weather, hot girls.
We had a lot of fun.
Oh, my God, yeah.
We're both angels, but we can be a little devilish girls too sometimes.
Ooh!
No? I'm just glad that I always had a friend and a companion to share this amazing experience we had. Yeah.
Life.
We're like same age. We both have two kids, so we're very similar that way. And we get to hang out with each other and have a great time.
The Fantasy Bra every year is such a major event. It's a huge, huge, huge honor for any of the models to get the Fantasy Bra. This year we decided to do two separate Fantasy Bras.
I can't imagine what Victoria's Secret would have been without these girls. The contributions that they've made are incalculable. It was just time to say thank you.
It's gonna be very special. You know, it's not even dream come true. It's more than that. It's more. You know, it's like it's always gonna be in my heart.
I can't wait to see it myself. I haven't seen it.
Yeah, we haven't even seen it.
the fantasy bra. Like, we're just like everybody else, you know? We're like, we can't wait to put our hands in our fantasy bra right now. We're like kids.
Our hands?
Yeah. Our
Ladies and gentlemen, Exotic Traveler featuring Ed Sheeran.
When your legs don't work like they used to before, and I can't sweep you up off your feet, will your mouth still remember the taste of my love? Will your eyes still smile from your cheeks? Girl, at night, we'll be loving you till we're 17. Baby, my heart still for lies.
Stand the models now, please. You fade the runway light. Stand by models now.
Nailed it! Yes!
Walking on stage for the Victoria's Secret runway is like being a rock star. The adrenaline rush you get is just indescribable.
The moment they put you in the lineup, that's kind of when the nerves set in.
No, we need to start the lineup.
I'm like, oh.
Your heart is like, boom, 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 boom. 20
seconds till curtain. Looking good.
Before I walk on, it's like total pandemonium going on. Like hyperventilating.
We need to get this on this cross.
First year I did the show, the producer on the side had to like push me out, like to get me to start walking because my legs just felt like bricks.
This must be.
Once you walk out there, all you can think about is don't fall or don't trip, don't screw this up.
I have to like force every step. My legs feel like jelly and I'm like, come on, let's sleep.
When you get in the end of the runway and it's your moment to shine, that's when you gotta give everything you have.
Nailing the end of the runway pose is like scoring a touchdown. It's very important.
Getting that right move or the right wink or the right kiss is so important. I mean, it's everything. It's such an extraordinary experience. It's a walk to remember.
When the show's done, you're like, what? No, let's do it again.
While I'm singing, can I like interact with you guys?
Yes,
like,
yes.
I wanna like spank the booty.
Why are we so nervous this year?
For Elsa.
Come on, quickly, quickly.
We have lineup.
Elsa's standing by.
Ladies and gentlemen, University of Pink, featuring Ariana Grande.
Tell me something I need to know. Then take my breath and never let it go. If you believe it.
Continues with Hozier and Taylor Swift's world premiere of Style. Only CBS. Still to come on the Victoria's Secret Fashion Show, the world's most beautiful angels and the mesmerizing Taylor Swift.
Truly a major part of the Victoria's Secret Fashion Show. They've become so iconic over the years. There are these amazing, gorgeous props. They're very expensive, and they take a lot of time to put together. One of the artisans makes the frame, another artisan might do the crystals, another one will make the feathers. So seeing them come to life is just a wonderful creative process. Oh my God, so pretty.
Beautiful.
So beautiful. The Gilded Angel section is probably the most opulent section that we've ever done. The wings are goddess-like and golden, and just what you think about when you think of a Victoria's Secret angel.
She looks amazing.
It takes a year to make all these outfits. You know, all the little details and little sparkles and feathers, and it's so much work. It's incredible. The fairy tale section is very much this beautiful dream in the woods. There's hand painting on very thin veil-like gossamer fabrics. It's really what you think about when you think about a beautiful fairy tale.
I'm in love with these wings. It's almost like a childhood fantasy coming true, because I always wanted to be a fairy, so now I am one.
Going into furry tomics.
Time is about to wear
all right.
Fairies! Candy's standing by.
You're right.
3, 2, 1.
Ladies and gentlemen, Fairy Tale featuring Hozier.
My lover's got to her. She's a giggle at a funeral. Was everybody's disapproval? Should've worshipped her sooner. If the heavens ever did speak, she's the last true mouthpiece. Every Sunday's getting more bleak. A fresh poison each week. We were born sick, you heard them say it. My church office door answered.
gorgeous there. Gorgeous.
I've been working for Victoria's Secret for 18 years.
Beautiful.
And it's probably impossible to say how lucky and blessed and fortunate I feel.
Part of the Victoria's Secret experience is getting to do that shoot with Russell James.
Beautiful.
He is a genius.
The cutest thing.
Shooting with Russell James.
Oh my gosh!
He's definitely different than other photographers.
Come on, look.
He's like a monkey on the set.
Keep filming.
He's jumping around.
Sometimes that's how it is.
He's like an extreme photographer. He likes to shoot in difficult situations and push us a little bit.
Be careful, wait, wait, careful. No risk.
There's always some joke being played on somebody.
Gorgeous, that's beautiful. Keep going.
When you're shooting lingerie, you need someone that's making you feel safe and comfortable and having a laugh while you're doing it. And Russell does that. It's so easy to let go when you're shooting with him.
He photographs women in a way that truly captures them, their power, their strength.
Beautiful, man. Can you color it? Yeah, that's gorgeous. Beautiful.
I'm really excited to be a part of Russell James' book, Angels.
His pictures are very tasteful. They're classic. They're inspiring. So, you know, I'm very proud of him.
Over the years, one of the great things is not just to get to know all these amazing people as models, but we've become, I'd say, something, a family, and that is something that means a lot to me.
I would drop anything to shoot with Russell because he's so good to me and he's so good to the girls, and we really are a family, and I love Russell very much.
That's a wrap.
Next, a television exclusive as Taylor Swift finishes the show with Star.
Unbelievable.
Only CBS.
Definitely one of the biggest passions in my life. I think because it was introduced to me at such an early age and I fell in love with it. I lived, breathed, dreamed ballet, of being the prima ballerina and being lifted in the air by the handsome principal dancer. I've had countless dreams like that. Ballet is passion. It's art in the most beautiful human form. There's so much emotion that you can express without a single word. Being a model, you're doing the same thing. You are seen and not heard. There's a story to tell, a character to tell that you're portraying through movement. It taught me so much that I use today. I owe my career to my background in ballet.
We're good to go.
All right, let's do it.